Hi, I'm Mike Hudson, Director of the Museum of the American Printing House for the Blind. Our mystery object today is the Hall Stereotype Machine. So Frank Hall is the principal of the Illinois School for the Blind, and in the spring of 1892, he has come out with the Hall Braille Writer, the first successful mechanical Braille Writer. But Hall was swinging for the fences. He was also interested in building a machine that would allow him to mass produce Braille. And so he goes back to his friends at the Munson Typewriter Company, and they help him come up with this design. It's basically a big console model, heavy duty Braille Writer. But instead of writing on paper, it writes on brass plates. So you've got the six keys of the typical Braille Writer, your space bar, and then down at the bottom is a foot pedal. So you press the keys, you press on that foot pedal, and that would drive the pins into the plate, embossing the Braille onto the plate. You could take these plates, put them into a clamshell style press or a rotary press, and mass produce Braille. Hall learned that his prototype machine was coming back from the Munson Typewriter Company in January of 1893, but Hall was in a little bit of a pickle. He was the appointee of the Democratic governor, and the Republicans had just taken over in the Illinois State House. Hall was worried that he was going to lose his job before he had a chance to finish the machine. So when he learns that his prototype has arrived at the train station in Jacksonville, he gets in a wagon, goes down to the train station in the middle of the night, brings the machine back to the printing shop at the Illinois School, and tinkers with it all night. By the morning, next morning, he's got his first finished plate. This machine revolutionizes Braille production for kids all over the United States.